The Office of the Solicitor General has asked the Supreme Court to issue a gag order against ABS-CBN, ABS-CBN Convergence, and its personalities to prevent them from speaking out against the Quo Warranto petition, which the OSG lodged against the media network.
The Supreme Court has ordered the respondents ABS-CBN Corporation and ABS-CBN Convergence, Inc. to file their respective comments to the motion filed by the Office of the Solicitor General within a period of non-extendable period of 5 days from receipt of notice.
In its motion, the OSG cited several reports aired and published on ABS-CBN's TV and online platforms accusing the network of engaging in propaganda, allegedly to get sympathy from the public, sway public opinion, and influence the resolution of the case.
Yan ang mangyayari kung masusunod ang petisyon ni Sojin Jose Calida sa Supreme Court.
Among these reports, a video explainer by Christian Isguera presenting the grounds of the OSG in asking for the revocation of the franchises of ABS-CBN and ABS-CBN Convergence, ABS-CBN's response, as well as a brief description of what a quo warranto proceeding means. The OSG also objected to reports on DZMM's news gathering efforts and the Supreme Court's order asking ABS-CBN to comment on the quo warranto petition, articles on ABS-CBN's website about the petition, and social media posts by the network's artists and personalities. Solicitor General Jose Calida says these violated the sub judice rule, which restricts comments and disclosures of parties regarding a pending judicial proceeding to avoid prejudging the issue, influencing the court, or obstructing the administration of justice. Calida says the courts must be free from outside interference and influence, noting that justices and judges are not immune from pervasive effects of the media. Malacañang expresses support for Calida.
Tama naman siya doon. Kasi parang nagiging emotional ang issue on this particular topic. It's much ado about nothing. It's not about press freedom.
Supreme Court spokesperson Brian Keith Hosaka clarifies the pending gag order motion should not have any effect on the impending Senate hearing.
I don't think that will matter because, first of all, the senators are not parties to the case.
But Hosaka can't say for now if ABS-CBN personalities, who were not named in the petition, will be lumped together with ABS-CBN Corporation, who is a party to the case. It is also unclear what the effect of the possible gag order would be on ABS-CBN News' coverage of the issue and if social media users will also be covered by the prohibition.
Let's just wait for the actual order of the court on this motion.
In a statement, Human Rights Watch says the OSG's motion is ridiculous. Not only does the OSG want to end ABS-CBN's franchise, it also wants to silence all critics on specious grounds. The group asks, why is the government so scared of independent opinions and a free press? For its part, the National Union of Journalists of the Philippines believes the OSG's move is an obvious attempt to silence all voices opposed to ABS-CBN's shutdown. ABS-CBN and ABS-CBN Convergence are set to file their comment to the Quo Warranto petition this week. Meanwhile, the Supreme Court en banc will convene Wednesday next week. Mike Navalio, ABS-CBN News.